Welcome back to NHL Goalie Breakdowns presented by MapSouth Goaltending. With a busy season of training for our program winding down, I'm excited to be back and bring you guys more content, and hopefully help improve your game while giving you a fix of the NHL while we await the upcoming season. Thank you for the continued support, and if you have missed any of our previous installments, they are posted on our Instagram account and YouTube channel. This week we will be focusing on rising star Igor Sheshterkin. Shesterkin may have been an unknown commodity to most NHL fans in North America, but he developed a reputation of being the best goalie not playing in the NHL. He dominated the junior and pro ranks in Russia. He was a two-time KHL All-Star, KHL Gagarin Cup champion, 2018 Olympic gold medalist, and had a save percentage of .933 or above in all three KHL seasons. His 2018-19 season was incredible. 28 games played, 1.1 goals against average, and a .953 save percentage. It was safe to say he was ready for the next challenge. With the Rangers having Lundqvist and Georgiev in the NHL, Sheshterkin started the year in the AHL, where he was named an All-Star before getting a call-up to the NHL. Upon arrival, he dominated in 12 games with a 10-2 record, 2.52 goals against average, and a .932 save percentage. Looking at the advanced statistics, it proves that there isn't sheer luck or low shot quality. He faced the second most high danger shots per 60 minutes at 10.32 and posted the fourth best save percentage in these situations of .849. And his goal saved above average per 60 minutes, 0.81, ranked second in the league. We will get into a tactical and technical breakdown of Shesterkin's game and show why he isn't going to be just a flash in the pan, but is a rising star in the National Hockey League. We will start the analysis of Shesterkin's game with line rush situations, starting off with his strengths and weaknesses when playing these situations. He's an outstanding athlete, and this will be demonstrated on lateral plays. And because he is so athletic, he tends to play with more depth than most goalies. Think critically when watching his depth selection to see if this is applicable to your game. Sheshterkin combines his high level of athleticism with a cerebral approach. He's very astute in identifying the situation around him and how the opposition is trying to attack him. Be sure to pay attention to his reads throughout this section. Sheshterkin is a natural puck tracker and combines this with very strong head and eye habits. He follows the puck extremely well throughout the save cycle and on passing plays. It's a very fun trait to watch and appreciate. In general, I do like Shesterkin's save selection, but there are a few plays where he gets overactive and ends up either overextending or digging in off his edges and pushing himself off angle, which causes some rebound control issues and goals against clips. We will explore a few of these clips ahead. Our first clip is a one-man attack with Gurionov getting to a loose puck. He's at the faceoff dot and ready to shoot. Notice Shesterkin's depth, a foot in front of the top of the crease. This is much more aggressive than most NHL goalies. The shot is taken low glove, and Shesterkin makes a solid save and notices head and eyes tracking the puck into his body and out. This is great use of visual attachment. Dubois of the Blue Jackets is in a puck battle with Brady Shea. Again, Shesterkin establishes aggressive depth on this one-man attack and starts his retreat. Dubois gets his stick free and shoots from the bottom of the hash mark. Even after a slight retreat, Sheshterkin is still aggressive and patient on his feet, trusting his tracking skills. The shot is high on his body and he's unable to contain it, but I like how he's able to stay patient and tall despite knowing he's going to take contact from his back checker. Now we're going to look at a couple partial and full breakaways. The first is a partial breakaway from Janmark that initiates at the blue line. Because this play develops quite quickly, Sheshterkin doesn't get quite as much initial depth as in previous clips, but prioritizes getting his feet set in preparation for his retreat. Janmark makes a quick move, shifting the puck away from his body onto his forehand in an attempt to open up the goalie before trying to slide at five-hole. Sheshterkin holds his edges and performs a controlled center shift right on top of the puck. Notice body position, shoulders in front of his hips, hands on top of the puck with an excellent seal on the ice. This is just a great sequence. Here's a breakaway from the opposition blue line by Evander Kane of the Sharks. A block shot ends up on Kane's stick, who has a breakaway while being pushed by Ranger backchecker Chris Kreider. With this play starting so far away, Sheshterkin elects a tremendous amount of initial depth. He's actually halfway between the bottom of the hash mark and top of his crease. Well, I can't say for certain, but my best guess is that with this solid back pressure, Igor is trying to force Kane to deke by taking away any shooting opportunities. As he retreats to the net, Kane pulls it from his forehand to backhand very quickly and tries to elevate. Shesterkin gets a very powerful push and suppresses the vertical angle by keeping his glove on a path in front of his body and gives the crowd a little windmill to boot. This clip shows a great job of managing the gap between player and goalie, great patience waiting for Kane to pull to his backhand, and finally, unbelievable visual attachment. Watch the freeze here as his head and eyes are directly on top of the puck as he tracks it into his glove hand. Not only does this save make the highlight reel because of the flash, the substance is a tremendous teaching tool as well. Now we'll move into multiple man attacks, starting with a Columbus Blue Jackets 2-on-1. Foligno starts with the puck and proceeds to drop it to Jenner. Due to his tremendous athleticism, Sheshterkin is a little more aggressive than most in these situations, but is ready to read and react from a relaxed stance. As Jenner hits the top of the circles, Sheshterkin moves into his reactive stance as Foligno makes a great play to disrupt the Rangers defender. Jenner fakes the shot and slides a nice pass to Foligno. Foligno goes skate to stick to get off a pretty good release despite a tough pass reception. Sheshterkin makes a solid toe save and pokes away the next threat. On the replay, you can tell that Jenner did a good job of locking up Sheshterkin on the shot fake, which forces him to slide fully extended. One of the tactical decisions I do like from Sheshterkin is that he still has a solid seal from the ground up, coming across paddle down a la Jonathan Quick in his prime. Sure, it's not an ideal position to be in, but his instincts are strong, and because of his elite athleticism, he gives himself a strong probability of making this save, despite being behind due to that solid shot fake. I do like his awareness to get the puck out of danger on the potential rebound as well. Here's a three-man Blue Jackets attack starting in the neutral zone. There's been a strong shift in how pro hockey teams attack off line rushes. As you can see, the Blue Jackets are stacked three across in a straight line. This forces the Rangers D pair to keep pushing back and also makes the Rangers back checker get sucked below the tops of the circles. This provides the puck carrier with a ton of options. He can shoot, pass to the mid lane, pass to the weak side, or drop to the second wave defenseman jumping up. If you've watched hockey a lot over the last couple of years, you'll see this fundamental shift in how line rushes are attacked offensively. In turn, this has made goaltending more difficult as Sheshterkin now has to account for numerous options. The Columbus player makes a great pop pass to the middle. And even after one pass, Sheshterkin still has to account for the second ladder pass, which is that backdoor option. Notice he's his well-balanced torso on top of the puck and has access to his edges in case of an additional lateral play. The Blue Jackets player moves towards Shesterkin's glove, and note how patient he is, holding his glove side edge, and waits until the shot is fully released before going down. What appears to be a straightforward save was a very dangerous threat and highlights all the different options a goalie has to face when playing against team rushes in the NHL and pro hockey today. Here is a goal against clip on a team line rush by the New Jersey Devils. Be sure to watch his save selection and if Sheshterkin sets his feet. The play starts with what should be a controlled 2-on-3 where the Rangers have numbers. Unfortunately, the backchecker over-backchecks, opening up a huge pocket behind the initial rush. A great pass is made to the second wave of New Jersey attackers, and Clayson rips a shot past Igor's ankle and on the glove side. While it was a great shot, watch the replay. It doesn't go post and in, and Sheshterkin doesn't even get a piece of it. I believe this is for two reasons. One, he doesn't set his feet, and as I've explored in other videos, that hinders our ability to track pucks through the save cycle. And two, his save selection. By leaving his glove side knee elevated, he can't get his shoulders on top of the puck, therefore can't fully extend into the shot. While it was a well-placed shot, I believe Sheshterkin is able to stop this with relative ease had he been stationary and used a more standard butterfly save selection. Here is our last line rush clip, and it features a four-man attack by the Kings. This clip shows Shesterkin's high level of athleticism and control. Even under duress, he just looks so efficient. The Kings enter the zone on what seems to be a contained entry until the near worst case breaks out for the Rangers. One Ranger wipes out and takes out another defenseman, creating a quick 4-on-2 scenario. The Kings puck carrier on the wall has numerous options as the fallen Rangers rally to get into position. I love Shesterkin's depth selection here as he's pretty well on the post, understanding that the puck carrier Martinez doesn't have much to shoot at and has high quality passing options at the net or slot area. He elects to pass net front to Toffoli, who tips it, and Sheshterkin makes an outstanding save on a controlled slide behind the stick blade. The puck pops up and a battle ensues. Watch on the replay here, the control and efficiency presented by Sheshterkin throughout it all. And I love how after the initial save, he's still in control of his body and limbs while constantly battling for the pucks and sight lines as the Rangers find a way to break out. Now we will move into in-zone situations, beginning with an analysis of Shesterkin's strengths and weaknesses on above-the-line plays. Watch throughout these clips on in-zone plays, particularly on point shots. His visual attachment skills are an extreme plus in his game, which leads to his next trait, his outstanding rebound control. He's like a sponge on perimeter plays and rarely gives up a secondary chance, even when dealing with traffic. It's extremely fun to watch and evaluate him make the game look easy. In all above-the-line situations, Sheshterkin does a great job of being patient on his feet, and I love his effective use of the relaxed stance. His timing is impeccable, and his understanding of when to use either the relaxed or reactive stance is a lesson for all goalies at any level. Again, we are going to highlight a goal against situation where he leaves his knee elevated. He does have a habit of this, and it's important to continue to emphasize why we want to avoid the safe selection for our viewers. This goal against clip starts as a stalled line rush by Columbus. Then Panarin's unable to pick up the puck and turns into an in-zone play. Bjorkstrand picks up the loose puck and utilizes the Rangers' D-man as a screen as he releases the shot back against the grain from the top of the slot. It is an excellent shot, as you'll see in the replay, as it rises just right under the crossbar. One thing to watch on the replay is Shesterkin's save selection. By leaving that knee elevated, he ends up sliding, digging in that edge and sliding slightly off angle. Had his knees driven together on the ice, he would have allowed himself the ability to maintain his angle, thus providing himself with the best opportunity to get his glove or shoulder on the puck. Obviously, this is an elite-level release and shot placement. For the majority of us watching, the shots we were facing aren't going to be that high and tight to the crossbar, with the shooters more likely to miss their target. Thus, we want to increase our probability and opportunity of making the save by focusing on quality positioning. Here's a broken play on a Columbus power play. The Rangers try to shrink the zone, as you can see all four penalty killers on one half the ice, in order to create a stalled puck or turnover. The Blue Jackets player does an excellent job relieving pressure to Bjorkstrand on the weak side. Bjorkstrand is able to walk into the forward tees and winds up for a slap shot. One thing to note, I do really like the Rangers' positioning with the net front D, as he does split the ice in half and eliminates a direct or slap pass option to the back door. Watch how efficiently Shesterkin plays this. He calmly moves into position, he's nice, relaxed, and balanced, and then while still being able to be ready to react with his toes stationed at the top of the crease. Shesterkin shows his elite visual attachment skills as he tracks the shot over his ankle and slightly shifts his body behind it and is able to steer it with his blocker to the half wall. Excellent save that he makes look very easy from a highly dangerous shooting position. Here's another penalty kill clip, and it starts as a pass from the goal line out in front by a driving Columbus attacker. I like how Shesterkin starts on his feet and releases perfectly behind the player's stick blade. He quickly recovers to his feet as the puck arrives at the blue line. Werenski slides on the blue line and watches Shesterkin does a great job looking over the proper side of the screen, utilizing an efficient, relaxed stance as Werenski really isn't much of a shooting threat from with his body position. The puck moves to the flanker at the top of the circle, who moves downhill towards the net. Shesterkin smoothly T-pushes to get in position, holding his relaxed stance as the shooter gets ready into his shooting position. You'll note that Shesterkin drops into his reactive stance and makes a solid save just over his ankle on the glove side. His head and eyes are on top of the puck and immediately recovers for the rebound. If we are being nitpicky, he does slide across under-rotated on his power slide, but that was because he was probably prioritizing getting over quick in the scramble situation. This clip highlights his outstanding visual attachment skills, his patience, and his efficiency, as he never looks rushed or panicked throughout this whole sequence. This clip starts as a broken line rush, with Shesterkin aggressively coming out to play a rolling puck. He doesn't get much on the shot, and is fortunate the puck redirects towards the half wall. Shesterkin calmly finds his footing as a turnover is created by Dallas, with Perry getting the puck on the faceoff dot. Note, Shesterkin doesn't rush out to gain unnecessary depth. From there, Perry makes a nice pass across the slot to Hintz, who is wide open. Hintz takes a quick shot high and back against the grain, which Shesterkin eats up and contains. Watch on the replay, Shesterkin beats the pass on his feet, toes stay inside the top of the crease as he prioritizes angle over depth. He does a nice job keeping his torso nice and tall and raises his right shoulder and elbow and comes underneath with his glove to create a basket for an unreal display of rebound control. This is an incredibly difficult shot to contain high on our chest and shoulder area. His pre-shot decision making put him in the best position to make this save and control the rebound. This is one of my favorite clips of Shesterkin. It's a Jets power play and they're spread out all around the perimeter. The puck moves to Wheeler on the half wall, who is one of the most dangerous passers in the league. The Jets slide into a 1-3-1 formation on their power play and the middleman takes a great route to get open. Wheeler threads the needle to Scheifele and unloads a quick half clap. Shesterkin makes an excellent blocker save sliding laterally. Watch again how Shesterkin plays this. He gets across on his feet to the pass to Wheeler. He holds his relaxed stance because Wheeler really isn't really threatening the net, which allows him to find sight lines. Watch as Shesterkin takes one last shoulder check to find the threats away from the puck. Wheeler then makes his pass, and Shesterkin explosively slides across the screen, finds the puck, and makes just a ridiculous save. What an awesome display of awareness and athleticism. Here's another point shot clip that shows how calm and efficient Shesterkin is when the play breaks down. The Jets' power play moves it to the middle man, who fires a quick one-timer from the top. It is a really difficult rebound to control, as it is tipped by Scheifele, and it hits near the top of Shesterkin's pads. This means he cannot get a stick on it, and it's very risky to try and catch this puck cleanly for fear that the tip ends up rising over or outside our glove. A battle ensues in front, and not once does Sheshterkin open up holes in his coverage, and he calmly and quickly finds the puck. Watch on the replay, as many goalies, even at the NHL level, would have panicked and started extending libs on the rebound attempt by Ehlers. But watch Sheshterkin as he maintains and trusts his position and finishes out the play. Here's our final above-the-line clip, and it really demonstrates Shesterkin's tracking skills and high-level athleticism on broken plays. Vlasic fires a point shot, and a deadly mid-zone tip occurs. Sheshterkin stays with it the whole time, tracks the puck to his glove, but is unable to secure it with all the mayhem around him. The bouncing puck moves to his right, and he smartly extends his body back towards the post, building the coverage from the ground up. And note, he never loses visual attachment this whole time. He loses his stick, but continues to read the play without any hesitation and maintains technique and efficiency. On the replay, watch how incredible this track is on the mid-zone tip. Whether it may have gone over the net or not is irrelevant, as it's just really fun to watch and appreciate him stay with it throughout the whole time. And this also shows that while he's usually in control, what makes him, and can sometimes make him look like an average athlete, his athleticism and explosiveness is absolutely elite when needed. Now we will move into low plays, beginning with what to watch for in Igor's game in these situations. This is a dominant trait throughout the video, but it must be touched on again because of how strong this area is for Sheshterkin. Watch how well he tracks passes, shots, and rebounds all around the net. He does a great job utilizing shoulder checks and non-threatening plays behind the net, and his incredible intelligence allows him to demonstrate the next trait as well. Sheshterkin generally does a great job holding his feet prior to committing into post play positions, which I really appreciate as it shows trust in his reads and is a great teaching tool for you as the viewers, and you can see how much more dynamic we are from our feet. Like many goalies, Sheshterkin is RVH dominant. He will occasionally use overlap or just hold his feet, and when he goes into RVH, he usually creates a great seal with many points of contact between himself and the post. We will highlight a bad goal against in our first clip, where he does create a poor seal and it causes a goal against. As just mentioned, here is a goal against clip which highlights the importance of securing proper points of contact in RVH. The Devils player receives a high to low pass on the goal line and Sheshterkin flows back to his post. Recognizing the shooter is ready to shoot, Sheshterkin starts to sink into RVH. The shot is taken and from this view it appears like there's no possible way this puck gets in. On the next two replays, notice that Sheshterkin is skate blade to post, which creates an imperfect seal. The puck ricochets off the toe of his pad and bounces in. This shows the importance of getting our toe box sealed in RVH. This is more picking on the play versus Shesterkin's technical use of RVH, as he is typically toe box to post, but it's more, again, we just want to make sure we're utilizing proper technique for us as viewers and goaltenders. Here's a dead angle line rush that turns into a low play situation. It begins with the Kings attacker on his backhand outside the dot trying to work towards the net. I don't necessarily agree with Igor's use of RVH here, as the Kings player only has one hand on a stick and is most certainly not a threat to shoot. One of the things I do like though is how Sheshterkin flows his blocker side skate towards the goal line and snaps his head around as he bumps post to post. Identifying from there that there is no shot or pass threat, I do love that he recovers to his feet. A broken King cycle ends up on the goal line, and Sheshterkin drops into RVH with a dead angle shot option. The Kings player drops it behind him to a second attacker, and I like how Sheshterkin uses his glove side skate to re-anchor and position his body to get a nice tall seal. The Kings player elects to shoot on the short side, and it looks like an easy block for Sheshterkin. What I do like on the replay is how patient he is holding his post, as many goalies would have started leaving their post for fear of a cross-crease walk, but he trusts his ability to get across if necessary and doesn't open anything up on the short side. Here's a low tip play by the Dallas Stars. It highlights Shesterkin's strong tracking skills and hockey IQ. Seguin picks a puck up on the wall and Sheshterkin tucks inside the post and drops into RVH as Seguin throws the puck to the net with Ben driving the mid lane. I like how Sheshterkin holds his post and absorbs this puck and tracks it all the way into his frame. Many goalies end up using the post as leverage and bumping off, which would create separation between the post for Ben to tip it in. Sheshterkin shows his high level of hockey IQ and decides to hold, which in turn makes the save look routine. This clip shows Sheshterkin using smart utilization of overlap. The Kings attacker drives wide and Sheshterkin takes a peek and identifies his defenders have numbers on the Kings weak side option. In recognizing this, Sheshterkin maintains his squareness and moves into an overlap position as the Kings attacker looks ready to shoot. The player continues his route around the net, and Igor quickly power slides on a great route to get tight to his glove side post. The pass comes out to Foley, who joined the rush late, and Sheshterkin pushes out on his feet and gets set immediately and makes an outstanding save on a one-timer. Great sequence by Sheshterkin that highlights intelligent use of overlap and then shows us great hockey IQ and decision-making on a dangerous pass-out. This clip is another pass-out that demonstrates every one of Shesterkin's low play strengths. It is a phenomenal clip to evaluate and encourage goalies to see how it plays out and how they can apply this to their own game. A slow dump-in is retrieved by Kopitar in the corner. Sheshterkin does a great job to gather information by doing a quick shoulder check. Kopitar changes sides with a cycle to the weak side. In this situation, many goalies we have watched in these breakdowns would have defaulted into RVH. I love that Igor beats this on his feet. A quick pass out is made to Toffoli in the slot. Because Sheshterkin is on his feet, he gets a strong push. In fact, he actually overshoots his angle slightly as Toffoli pulls the puck into his body to release the shot. Sheshterkin gets to his glove side edge ridiculously fast and changes direction to get his body centered and square. He pulls the backside or glove side of his body nice and tight and tracks it right into his pant area and contains. This is a ridiculously high-level sequence that makes look relatively easy because of his tactical and athletic traits in low-play situations. The sequence starts with a Sharks player on the point, intentionally shooting a puck off the end wall to create a bounce back towards the net. Sheshterkin slides into RVH. Once again, note that he allows his inside skate to rotate towards the goal line. This allows him to smoothly bump to his glove side post. A quick pop pass occurs to the strong side option just above the goal line. Sheshterkin does a great job of rotating his blocker side skate up to square his body up as the shot is taken. Had he stayed completely flat, there's a strong possibility that he gets scored on. The puck pops up, and watch him track in this puck. His head and eyes never leave it, and he's able to secure the cover. Great sequence highlighting some strong detail-oriented aspects of Igor's game. Here's our last clip of the Sheshterkin breakdown. The puck moves behind the net to Toffoli, and note that Sheshterkin beats this original pass on his feet. Toffoli makes a great pass to the slot, and watch as Igor pushes directly on top of the puck, right behind the shooter's stick blade, in order to maximize his coverage. The rebound pops out to his glove side, and look how he uses the post as leverage to push. It almost looks like he has springs in his legs. Fully extended, I like his decision to keep his paddle flush and to the ice to seal his five hole. We saw a similar clip earlier in our breakdown. He then covers it up and kills the play. Excellent sequence demonstrating how important it is to beat passes on our feet, even behind the net, and great athleticism to compete to finish this play. Thank you for watching, and please continue to share your comments and feedbacks. Also, keep an eye out for new content and training options that are being released next week.